The weather in the Orcades this week has been terrific. The gale of west winds has raged for the last few days, with such violence as to put an end to any communication between these islands and the south. We regret to state that accidents have been many. A fat old lady has been caught up and whirled across the Peary Sea and deposited on the top of a pigsty the other side of Wideford Hill. It happened to be an intensely dark night, and the old lady went for a constitutional walk, taking with her a lantern. The effects of this transit through the air was so that Provost Reed rushed out of his office exclaiming, "Eee, boys, seeking a sight, there's a comic." "Comic yourself," screamed the old lady from upper stratum, whereupon Bailey Reed, being so flabbergasted, fainted away on the spot, and afterwards, as soon as he recovered his equilibrium, forthwith indiked an epistle to the editors of Roundabout St. Magnus, inquiring if he or any of his scientific correspondents ever heard of a speaking comic. The poor old lady, after the severe shocks, was heard to exclaim in a pathetic tone and voice, "Hexers, to think that I should take a flea afore me time." The mistress of the farm came out, and seeing the old lady seated there, she went up to her and kindly asked, "And how's your fair body?" Which so exasperated the irritable old lady that she fiercely exclaimed, "You be blowed yourself and see how you like it."
Thank you. There was once a man who thought he could make a steam engine to go with steam. While he was trying to know how it would go, his brain burst. His grandmother's aunt came into the room and sent for the doctor. But before he came, his head burst. The doctor came and tied it with a bit of twine, and that was the end of the man. The moral of the story is we should not try to do impossible things.